Hello friends, in this video we will learn design of columns. So before going further, we see some important things. So here firstly we will see how to calculate the load on column if we want to design practically a building in which we need to design a column, then how to calculate the load. Then after calculating the load, how to find out the reinforcement, that is main reinforcement and stirrups. So here important note is, for there are three types of column. One is the pedestal, another one is the short column, and third one is the long column. So in pedestal, so L divided by B ratio is less than 3. For short columns, 3 is less than equal to L by B is less than equal to 12, and for long columns L by B ratio is greater than 12. So now what is mean by L and what is mean by B, where L is the effective length of column and B is the least lateral dimension of column. So if column is square, so least, which one is least dimension? Then if column is circular, then we can directly take the dimension, that is the B. Then types of loads on column are, there are 5 types of loads on column. First is the self weight of column. So self weight of column into number of floors will get the load. Then self weight of beam per running meter. As we know, in RCC, transfer of load takes place in following way, that is the load of slab to beam, from beam to column, and column to footing. So here self weight of beam per running meter. Then loads of walls per running meter. Then total load of slab, that is the dead load, live load plus self weight. So DL, LL is the dead load, live load. And next is the bending moment. So these are the 5 types of load on column. Then now some important assumptions based on the experience and the rules and regulations for calculating the loads on column. So for columns, self weight of concrete is 2400 kg per meter cube, which is equivalent to 240 kN load. Self weight of steel is 8000 kg per meter cube, which is equivalent to 800 kN. I assume self weight of column is always 10 to 15 kN. So based on the experience, you can assume or you can calculate the based on the this weight of concrete and weight of steel, you can calculate the self weight of column. Then for beams, I assume self weight of column is 2.5 kN per running meter. For size of beam, 230 mm by 450 mm. Based on this, you can calculate the this weight. For walls, density of bricks is equal to 1500 to 2000 kg per meter cube. For 6 inch thick wall, 1 meter length and 3 meter height, load per running meter is 0.150 into 1 into 3 into 2000, which is equivalent to 900 kg. So this way you can calculate or you can assume the loads. Then for slabs, assume thickness of slab is 125 mm. Self weight of slab is equal to 0.125 into for 1 meter length. We can calculate the self weight of slab for 1 meter length. That's why I have taken here 1 meter. Then 2400 is the density of concrete, then which is equivalent to 300 kg, which is equal to 3 kN. So then finishing load, 1 kN per meter. Superimposed live load is equal to 2 kN per meter. Factor of safety 1.5. you can refer IS 875 part 1, part 2, part 3 and IS 456 for the design. Then design of column, solved numericals. So here design a short column carrying a load of 500 kN, use M20 concrete grade, Fe415 steel grade, design lateral ties also, assume column is square. So lateral ties mean these are the stirrups. Then total load P is equal to sigma CC into AC plus sigma SC into ASC, where sigma CC is the permissible stress in concrete in direct compression, AC is the cross-sectional area of concrete, excluding any finishing material and reinforcing steel. Sigma SC is the permissible compressive stress for column bars. ASC is the cross section area of longitudinal sill. Now sigma CC is 5 Newton per mm square, sigma SC is equal to 190 Newton per mm square. Assume ASC is equal to 1 upon 100 into AG. AG is the cross sectional area of column. So as per IS 456, I'll get these values. Then AC is equal to AG, area of AC means area of concrete is equal to AG gross area of column minus ASC area of steel in column. P is equal to sigma CC into AC plus sigma SC into ASC. We'll put the values and we'll get AG gross cross sectional area of column, gross cross sectional area of column 72,992.70 mm square. Then therefore sides of columns are equal to, as column is square, in the numerical they have given column is square, so square root of this will get 270.17 mm is the size of column. So provide size of column 275 mm by 275 mm as it is square column, and where which every always we should provide the higher side. So here 270.17, so we are providing 270.5. now area of steel is equal to ASC is equal to 0.01, AG is equal to 0.01 into this area is equal to 729.93 mm. provide 8 bars of 12 mm pi. So these are some assumptions. We are assuming the 8 bars of 12 mm pi, 10 bars. We calculate, we should provide this area AG, this area we should provide. So how to calculate? Therefore area of steel provided, area of steel provided is equal to area of steel. Here area of steel, we have calculated this area. We should provide area, this much area of steel. We can provide excess area, but we cannot provide less than this. So then we are providing 8 bars of 12 mm diameter. Therefore area of steel required is provided, is equal to required this much. Provided is 8 into pi by 4 into 12 square is equal to 904 mm square. As this area is more, provided area is more than the required area, then our design is okay. Then now design of lateral ties, that is the stirrups. So pitch, of stirrups means spacing between two stirrups. There are three distances as per IS values, IS 456. Pitch S should not be greater than 275 mm, or S pitch should not be greater than 300 mm, or this pitch should not be greater than 16.5, which is equal to 16 into 5 is 12 mm diameter. So main reinforcement, 16 into main reinforcement diameter of bar, that is 192 mm, and 275 is the size of column 300 mm and 16.5. Among these three, this 1, 2, 3, among that three we are selecting lesser value, that is 192. So provide 6 mm diameter lateral ties at a distance of 192 mm center to center. Thank you for watching the video. If you like it, please do share and subscribe the channel for more fruitful videos. In the next videos we are seeing some estimation costing videos, or some engineering mechanics videos, or some other elements of building, that it may be a beam design, column beam design, slab design, one way slab, two way slab, that we'll see. Thank you for watching the video. If you like it, please do share the video and subscribe the channel, and thank you for watching the videos.